Hello. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to Coverity Policy Manager, a part of the Coverity development testing platform that helps you govern and enforce development testing across your organization. Policy Manager enables you to define and enforce a consistent standard for code quality, security, and testing across your organization. The configurable views allow you to select the development metrics and thresholds that align to your objectives, with the flexibility to switch gears as your priorities change throughout the course of your project. The data supporting the metrics used in Policy Manager comes from Coverity Connect. And because Coverity Connect interfaces with the rest of your development tools, your metrics can be based on data available from all aspects of your development process. This is important because you need visibility into any issues that might impact time to market, especially as a project nears its release deadline. The power of Coverity Policy Manager lies in its customizable hierarchies that allow you to put development risk into actionable contexts. You get visibility into policy compliance based on components, projects, teams, offices, or whatever hierarchy is useful to you. To help you understand what I mean, let's open a hierarchy based on projects and components. Each of these heat maps displays the hierarchy, with all projects in the center, and projects, subsystems, and components in consecutive rings. Note how the charts enable me to quickly understand the status of my development effort. This bar chart shows me that the vast majority of my outstanding issues are legacy or baseline issues that I don't want to focus on. Good, we're doing a pretty good job of keeping the new code clean. These heat maps allow me to quickly see that compliance to the testing policy and defect density is pretty good too. There are a few areas of concern that are highlighted in yellow and red, which we'll come back to. I also added a heat map for the legacy issues for comparison. Scrolling down, I can see that, most of the non-legacy issues are high impact, while the legacy issues have a more reasonable distribution. I can see the impact of our legacy burndown sprint a few weeks ago in the legacy chart, and I can also see a slight upward trend in the outstanding non-legacy issue count. I need to do something about that. Most of my issues are test policy violations as opposed to defects, so let's zoom in on the test policy heat map. This heat map makes it really easy to see which nodes are out of compliance. The test policy is based on the number of test policy violations per line of code in each node. Because the root node is green, we're generally in good shape. There are a few red nodes towards the bottom, so let's see what's going on there. One of the nice things about Policy Manager is that you can zoom all the way down to the source code. In this case, the server node has 27 violations of the testing policy. Each one of these indicates that there's important code that's not covered by a test case. For example, this one here identifies a warning case that is not being tested. There will obviously be users that are not interested in that level of detail, but for the team leads and mid-level managers, it can make the difference between knowing there's a problem and knowing how to fix it. Note that this all works regardless of code or defect origin. We have users that evaluate open source code with Policy Manager before they integrate it with their product. We have users that use it as an acceptance test for outsourced code. Even when issues are coming from third-party analysis tools, Coverity Connect and Policy Manager will assemble the big picture so you can pinpoint areas of risk, focus your efforts, and track improvement over time. Speaking of improvement over time, another area that Policy Manager helps you enforce is usage of the platform itself. If it's not being used, it's obviously not adding value. Many users define an adoption policy with an associated heat map. This one lets me easily see that folks are using the platform as I would like. In fact, I can see that daily use is increasing, and as expected, the lines of code are roughly staying the same. Another area of concern is in unassigned issues. I want all issues to have an owner so that nothing falls through the cracks. Thankfully, I can see that there are currently no unassigned non-legacy issues, and folks are not dismissing an inordinate number of issues either. Overall, things look pretty good, and I have a few hotspots to follow up on with my team leads. Speaking of team leads, they'll often focus exclusively on their area of responsibility. Policy Manager makes things easy for them, too. They can just navigate to the node of interest and immediately have the same information available for their projects. Since the same policies apply to all users, there should be no confusion about priorities. Focusing on policy violations will necessarily address the things that management cares about. Note that the charts and even the layout of the pages is configurable to ensure that the information you need most is always within arm's reach. You can even share charts and dashboards with other users if you need to ensure that everybody sees things the same way. In summary, Policy Manager gives you the visibility, traceability, consistency, and predictability you need to make better decisions and release with confidence. Thank you for taking the time to learn more about Coverity Policy Manager. For more information about the Coverity development testing platform, please visit coverity.com, send us a message, or request a trial.